wild by the whole blown vision at first, just like you. I bought into the whole marketing package, the betterment of life through hyperconnectivity and all that. Sure, they do that stuff. They are visionaries up at the top. Humanitarians. Bloom has helped me to educate the underprivileged. They've gone green. They fund everything from social programs to medical research. These things are real. But you know whose desk I'm sitting in? Raymond fucking Kenny. That'll wake you up real fast. So, since I'm the ghost of Ray Kenny, simply by desk location, I get to hear everybody's fucking Ray Kenny story. In one woman's case, it really was a fucking Ray Kenny story. And that's an ugly one. I about lost it the first couple of weeks until I realized something. Ray had it all figured out. With his hands in the guts of the CTOS, he began to see the real sinister potential of the thing he built. How do I know this? Because the ghost of Ray Kenny still haunts the data. He knew it would take another engineer to find it, somebody operating on the same level. Well, congrats to me. I guess that means I'm one of the smart ones. So here's my contribution to Ray's legacy. Apparently, you found me embedded in the system, just like I found him. Only I won't presume mine was as well hidden. It doesn't matter. I'm long gone anyway. I'm gonna play you some of Ray's greatest hits, as well as some of my own. Maybe one day this will all come back to bite Bloom in the ass. Probably not. Here, I'll play you some Ray.
Inviting Bloom to build CTOS in your city is like inviting a fucking vampire over for dinner and handing him a goddamn straw.
So, what's Bloom doing with all our data? I may have sneaked a peek. Sorry. Charlotte and her PR brigade aren't totally lying about how they use it. They're speeding things up, making life more convenient. But the right hand doesn't know what the asshole is doing. Go ahead. Listen.
Now the suits are already putting a price on the data they're collecting. They've been romancing advertisers and politicians. Shit. The mayor himself had a date with a couple of them last week. Now none of this comes as a surprise, so why are they all hiding all this from the board of directors? Something else. Something I'm missing.
The bosses are talking about the long-term global CTOS potential. At least in the countries that can afford it. They say it with stars in their eyes. They mention world changers like Thomas Edison and Alexander Graham Bell. You almost want to believe them. But then you realize they could actually pull it off. Ray put it best.
Imagine every major city, American, European, Asian, whatever, is now the same city. Sharing instant surveillance, constantly feeding each other data about you. Now mix in the special ingredients, prediction algorithms, feedback loops, subliminal messaging. Christ. I helped them build this thing and I can stop it. This is so big they don't have all the pieces yet. I still have time to act.
I'm going to let Ray take this one.
I'm on the verge of my third strike now. So they've taken away a lot of my access. Prepping for my big meltdown, I guess. They've handed Rose a new task. They want to start work on a behavioral prediction system. She'll never do it. I worry that if they give it to Tobias, he'll actually pull it off. His OCD cannot resist a challenge. So if we're gonna burn this thing, we may have to implicate the poor bastard.
According to my coworkers, they sent security down to escort Ray out like some kind of criminal. He didn't even get to gather all his things. I still have one of his ugly sculptures on my desk. He kicked and screamed the whole way out, which gave Bloom all they needed to put an HR spin on it. I'll read it for you. We apologize for the disruption caused on Tuesday when we ended our contract with Raymond Kenny. As a reminder, your medical insurance covers psychiatric consultations. We wish Mr. Kenny a speedy recovery, and we must stress that importance of confidentiality to all Bloom employees. I'll do my best to read translation. Mr. Kenny was batshit crazy, and don't you dare repeat anything he said or your ass is grass. Ray lashed out and took down the power to most of the Northeast. People panicked. People died. A lot of money was lost. He was making a point, demonstrating the dangers of relying on one system to keep everything running. Was it terrorism? I guess so. I mean, it's pretty much the definition, right? Rose Washington? She took a more traditional route in her whistleblowing and picked up a few headlines. But her proximity to Ray quickly discredited her. Tobias Furlan? I don't think anybody noticed him leave. He just wasn't there one day. Ray's still on the run, too. Is he a threat? Bloom seems to think so. Every so often, we get an email warning us to report any contact from former employees. But we all know which one they mean. I've been asked to pick up the reins on the prediction software. They call it Bellwether, and I suspect it's everything Ray Kenny feared. Just like Ray, I was asked to keep my work between me and a few specific managers. I could go higher up, I could out them and maybe even stop this, but I want to play along a bit more. I want to see where this all is going. Something they can't deny when it goes public. I can't believe I'm actually considered whistleblowing. I hate the spotlight. I'm weighing other options. There's a hacker group that might be able to do something with this information. They call themselves DedSec. So, I've been working on my own hello world for the Bellwether to see if it's really as insidious as I suspect it is. Does the Fibonacci sequence mean anything to you? It's always been one of my favorites. I'm gonna throw the Fibonacci numbers out there. Bellwether should predict where they can have the most subliminal influence, saturating the city within days. The CTOS will then monitor for impact. If I see instances of those numbers echo back throughout the city, everything I feared would be in motion. At that point, I'm sending proof to DedSec and they can do whatever they do to make things right. Shit. I checked the top lottery numbers that people played this month. Fibonacci. I've been hearing people talk about them on the L, on the news last night, a blurb about Fibonacci. I don't even need to read the CTOS report. The Bellwether worked. I sent Fibonacci through the CTOS and the people of Chicago echoed it back. So I guess this is it. Raymond Kenny was right.